been doing this show anyway?
Roll off. I don't know, but it's getting bad. Here we are, the top of Mount Zion here, the circular ballroom. We're just flashing around. Look at those lights going off all over the place.
Yes, Dollar, I tell you what. You know, being here in this church when I was walking over here, I found out something interesting about you. You are not...
After all these years, you found out there's something interesting about me?
Well, I've done a lot of interesting things, but there's things I can't tell. But in the neighborhood, I understand they called you Baseball Denver.
Yep. Oh, man, I can hit him out. I was great.
No. That's not why they called you Baseball Denver. They called you Baseball Denver because you're always getting thrown out at home.
Can they call you Dr. Bitner now?
I tell
more Cheerios.
Sears and robots.
Sears and robots. That's what I understand. Well, I'll give you one more chance.
You're going to help me out.
Since you're a doctor of theology now, what is the one question you cannot honestly answer yes to? Nobody can answer yes.
Do I like tuna noodle casserole?
Yeah. Nobody can answer.
The one question that nobody can answer yes to. Are you good looking?
Are you asleep?
Sometimes it's hard to tell.
Why don't you get into the next act?
Okay, tonight we've got Deanna Eggemeyer and Katie Bitner. She spells her name wrong. It sounds like Bitner, but it's Bitner. D-I-T-T-M-E-R. And they are going to pom-pom us away.
Doctorate degree.
Well, Vic,
This is. We got a big audience here tonight.
Some of them are bigger than others. You notice that? This one over here, right in the middle.
But you know, I can identify with that. I do a lot of that on Sunday morning. About the time you stand up.
Let's move on here. We gotta keep this show going.
Okay, alright. How is a little girl, how is a girl like a small bucket?
How is a girl like a small bucket?
When she's a little pale.
Jokes were getting better for a moment there, but no such luck. We would like to share with you a brief story of a young man whose name let us call Kapu. He was a short young man about this tall, who started out in his land of Laos. But there was terrible political change that happened in Laos, and they lost their freedom. So, this Mr. Kapu decided to escape. He escaped to Thailand, where he spent 8 months in a camp. Unfortunately, there isn't much to do in a camp except sleep, eat, and get into other trouble. After his time in the camp, that's enough. Mr. Kampu was able to catch a flight to Hong Kong, where he spent one night. He was taken to his hotel on that first night in Hong Kong and ushered up to his floor, up to his room on the 11th floor. They went in the elevator and up 11 flights to his room. He was ushered out to his room, went into his room, put down his bags, and went out and went down the elevator again to look around the sights of Hong Kong. He went out into the elevator again to see the sights of Hong Kong. Of course, when he returned, he realized he had forgotten what floor he was on. So he had to press 11 buttons. And as the door opened on each floor, poke his head out to see if it was his floor. He eventually found his place to sleep that first night. The next day, our little man, Mr. Kampu, flew off to Tokyo, where the plane refueled. And then on to Seattle, where the weather was cold, though he was wearing shorts and had his first experience of North American winter. Nice stage directions. After his time in Seattle, he flew again to New York, and after a short stay in New York, to Pennsylvania, where he lived and where his host family had provided for him, in the little town of Edwardsville, Pennsylvania. Well, his sponsor had brought him clothes and a variety of other things to get him going, and so on his first day, when he decided to go out looking for a job, he got all dressed up in the clothes that the family had provided for him. He got dressed to go to his first job interview. Wearing pants, shirts, a woman's coat, and women's high heels. He didn't get the job. But he had learned his lesson in Hong Kong, and as he went to the job interview, he would walk 3 blocks, look back to make sure he knew where he had come from, walk 3 more blocks, He didn't want to end up on the wrong block, so he found his way back to his house in Pennsylvania. Well, after a few short jobs there, he moved on again in the long travels of this new immigrant to Elgin, and then finally to Joliet, where he settled down and began work at the aluminum company. One day, he went to work with his lunch bucket, and as he was at work, he saw a television commercial for McDonald's and saw a wonderful advertisement for the Big Mac hamburger that looked so scrumptious that he just had to have one. So on his lunch break, he decided to go over to McDonald's to get one of those special hamburgers. And he went into the counter.
Can you give me a McDonald?
What?
A McDonald?
What do you want?
Hamburger.
He went away confused because he just got one of those regular hamburgers and he was wanting to get one of the special ones. So he watched the commercial one more time and thought, maybe I just said it wrong. So the next day he also went back to McDonald's to try and get one of those Big Macs. The person at the counter was the same. May I help you? He looked around to see if anyone was watching, not wanting to embarrass himself again.
Can you give me a McDonald's?
What?
Hamburger.
He watched television a couple more times trying to figure out exactly what it was how to pronounce that strange hamburger's name so that he could get one of those scrumptious hamburgers. Well, he came back for the third time, and he was very cautious this time because he didn't want to embarrass himself for a third time at McDonald's. May I help you?
Can you give me a McDonald's?
What?
Burger.
A few years later, he did figure it out. The life and trials of a new immigrant.
And then for for dessert, I've got the Coca-Cola's chocolate. Oh. And to wash it down, a bottle of Dom Pérignon. What do you have in your lunch today?
Well, let me see. Of
How is... These girls know about boys.
Yeah.
How is a boy like a pony?
When he's a little horse.
So many people are falling into secure oblivion. I refuse to shed tears for my shortcomings anymore. I am comfortable and sane and smiling, running towards the arms of God this evening. And, hi Kate. Kate can't read. And this is a poem that I think is really beautiful, and it was written by a man called N. Scott Momaday, and it reminds me of cornfields. When you're out walking and you're not hunting. North Dakota, North Love. The cold comes about among the sheer, loosened plains. Rabbits rest in the foreground. The sky is clenched upon them. A glassy wind glances from the ball of bone in my wrist, even as I brace myself, and I cannot conceive of summer. And another man in me stands for it, wills even to remain, figuratively fixed, among the hard, hunchbacked rabbits, among the sheer, shining plains. So that's it, much more.
Thumping all these good ones. You know, since it's almost spring, this is a springtime question.
Springtime question. We're ready. Go.
On what side of a house should you plant a rose bush?
On what side? Now, Austin, he walks in the gardens. He knows all this. What side of the house should you plant a rose bush?
The outside.
The outside. Whoa. Bring up Rusty Scott. Rusty, where are you? Come on up.
Can't help.
My love, my only true love. We were the talk of the town.
They were always talking about us, never to us. Rudy, my love, your ears like antenna. I will never forget you, Ruthie. Ruthie, my love. Oh, we were seniors that year. Ruthie, that fateful, that wonderful year. It was the end of the year, and you and I were going to the prom. Just you and me. You in shimmery satin, me in black velvet. Ruthie, my love. We danced, we were elected king and queen. You didn't believe it, I didn't believe it, no one believed it. But we were elected. My love. Oh, Ruthie, those flowers look so good on you. What color were they? I don't know. I remember that night. The evening ended. We had danced every song. We were a sweaty mess. And we headed off in my rusty red Pinto. Headed home through those mountain roads, through those mountain passes. Ruthie, it was slick. I tried to control the car. Oh, Ruthie, Ruthie, my love. But Ruthie, I was so excited that night. I kept going faster and faster, and Ruthie, you know I didn't want to slip off that curb. Ruthie, oh, the car went off, but miraculously somehow, Ruthie, I grabbed the branch, and Ruthie, I had one hand on the branch and one hand on you. Ruthie, I was holding on for all I could. Ruthie, one hand on the branch, the car plummeting down in flames. One hand on the branch and one hand on you. Oh, Ruthie, I was holding on for everything. But as I said, it was a sweaty night, Ruthie. And my hands were slipping. What? And my deodorant failed. I was holding on for everything I was. But my hands were slipping, Ruthie. And Ruthie, I couldn't hold to both. So my hands were slipping, and I had to let go.
See a bunch of Zion kids spend the best week of their life
at one of our church camps. Quit reflecting on
my Well, you
my
said
head.
You quit after birthdays. You don't have to tell your hair about that.
And so we really want to thank you for being here tonight and being a part of this. And because all the proceeds that are raised tonight are going to go, and by the way, everything that you eat has already been donated, so that means that everything that comes in for this wonderful talent that you're seeing is going to go into our scholarship fund, and our kids are going to be able to take part in the summer. So give yourselves a hand. About this, but the last count I had was well over 200 are packed in here tonight. So did you have another dumb question?
I never have a dumb question. You have dumb answers. How does a monster stop from dying?
Where did you get this?
Oh, I pick them up all year long.
How does a monster stop from dying, Vic? I don't know.
It goes into the living room.
And so tonight we have the very best in Zion fashions for you.
Introducing the print dress. Make sure you look at the type. Worn by Flo Horst. And our next show of just wonderful fashion is a 10-gallon hat worn by Brian Shore. Notice the 10 gallons. Next on the list is a seersucker dress by Sears, worn by Sue Campbell. Next we have a pair of baggy pants. Make sure you check the bags. Worn by Glenn Borst. Just look at those bags. Now, make sure you catch this slip-over sweater by Bea Hakes. Shorts designed by Jansen, worn by Dan Scott. This is the new summer look. I'm sure you'll see a lot of those at the beach this year. Foster. Notice the detail of the frame as it glistens as she walks across the floor. Now, thinking of summer, let's go tubing with Polly's Tube Top.
Cool.
I think I've got this one, Dick.
Why didn't the skeleton cross the road?
Flesh was
a Everybody knows that one, Dick.
Why didn't the skeleton cross the road?
Look at that guy, he's got the answer, and he didn't even have a doctor's degree. What's the answer?
He didn't have the guts.
He didn't have any guts. Did the chicken cross the playground?
Get out
Why did the chicken cross the playground? I don't know.
To get to the other slide.
Well, we've got a surprise for you right now. We've got David Miner and Paul Phil Weber, the great magicians.
Thank you. Now we're going to do our comedy tricks.
Oh, mustache, if you'll only
is Sunday. As soon as I get to church, I can't wait to have lunch.
Yeah, I really work up an appetite.
Yeah.
I know I do.
Yeah. What you got for lunch today?
Vic, let's look and see what I got for lunch today. Well, Victor, I got some good stuff in here. I got cottage cheese with dill sauce. And then I've got me some chicken with beets and onions. Then some veal and pork pate. And then for a vegetable, I've got some spinach and artichokes with cream sauce. And then for dessert, I've got some of that New York cheesecake. And they'll watch it down with a bottle of Chateau Lelouch de Pop. What do you have in your lunch today?
Yeah, I'm really hungry. Let me see.
What do you got?
Today, I got...
Home too. are truly blessed this day to have His Holy Father in our midst. Pope Bill will be with us. And as a special treat, I welcome the choir from our own order of Saint Rachel, who will be performing for you today. Please welcome the sisters. We have Sister Mary Betty Boo. I have Sister Mary Sower. Sister Mary Dewey Decimal. And Sister Mary Hoover Vacuum. Sister Mary Secretary. And Sister Mary Foggy Disc. And Sister Mary, wish I wasn't here. Sister Mary Sabadi. Sister Mary Helen Pink. Sister Mary Lloyd J. Harris. And Sister Mary Mama to be the second. Sister Merry Christmas. And Sister Mary missed her calling. Sister Mary Alderwoman. And their director, Sister Mary Whoopee. Thank you.
Jerusalem's become a real drag. Everybody hates me.
Not that guy over there.
They all say he's different. They say he's really weird.
We don't care what people say. To us, he's always there.
Really?
The Friendship Circle, the Social Ministry Committee,
the Amaranth group has brought the cakes. Saturday Night Live is helping with salads and bread and stuff, and a number of folks donated the food, so we want to thank all those. Give them all a big hand. I don't know if I can get her back in here. Where's Bea Hicks? Is Bea our directress, Mother Superior, out there? Talk about broadcasting, huh? Where's Mother Superior? Here she comes. Give her a big hand.
This is always so much fun, and you know, we never rehearse. We just come here and get the act.
We rehearse.
The rehearse.
Okay. We practice a lot.
They go to the library a lot, too. So anyway, thanks again, all of you. I think this is the biggest crowd we've had, and it sure has been fun. That circle is absolutely the loomiest circle there is in this church. If you want something funny, just ask Rachel's circle. We're going to do it different tonight. We're going to go down and be seated, and we're going to be served. That'd be nice. So, as soon as the pastor pronounces the benediction, or no, the table grace, that's the wrong end of the day, we'll go down, and somebody will take your tickets, and you just go and be seated. Okay, thanks again for coming.
Denver, we're going to need some chairs downstairs.
Okay, with those of you who are
the voice from on high,
between the ages of 30 and 55, would you please, men, carry two chairs with you as you go down, and that should be enough chairs. Just slide them right out. Okay, let's hold on here for a second. You know, folks, God is really good to us. He gives us a sense of community, a sense of laughter, and we are indeed blessed. We're blessed to have our children and the opportunity to have them have an experience at our camp. There are many things for us to be thankful for. Let us ask a word of thanks, and then I'd ask you to close our prayer. I'll speak a few words, and then if we could close by singing together the table prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for this night. We thank you for those that have been willing to risk getting up on the stage and doing some things for their church. And we ask, Lord, that those gifts would be well used now as we think of what can come of this night. We ask you to continue to help us to be friends to one another, to be able to laugh one another and enjoy one another's company. We ask you to bless the food that we share tonight. We remember those, Lord, that don't always have enough. We thank you that there are times when, as a church, we're able to share what we have with others. Help us to be more generous so that all we have enough to eat. We ask now, Lord, your blessing upon us as we share this meal together. And let us sing together.
Be present at our table.
There's Pastor Bitner.
Sometimes I thought it was good.
Yeah.
trick.